Thinking aloud. Conversations on the leading edge of knowledge and discovery with psychologist Jeffrey Mishlove.
In fact, you can perfectly allow tachyonic particles in the theory of relativity.
Uh-huh.
They're paradoxical because, as I said, they have imaginary mass, which seems very strange. They can never slow down slower than the speed of light.
Mm-hmm.
At the speed of light, they have almost infinite. They have infinite energy. Mm. As they approach infinite speeds, they have no energy. So this is totally the opposite of the way our massive particles at zero speed have no energy, but as you approach the speed of light, they have infinite energy.
Uh-huh.
So just the reverse for tachyons.
Okay.
They have infinite energy at the speed of light, but as you speed up, no energy. So that's why the tachyonic fields are very appealing to me, because there's not an energetic, it's not energy mm-hmm. that's making thought. It's the tachyonic fields themselves that are the source of thought.
Mm-hmm.
And in my book, Time Loops and Space Twists, I devote a whole chapter as to why that occurs and how it occurs.
Mm-hmm.
And it involves something called the Doppler effect, which mm-hmm. is well known to people, but you can look it up and see how this applies when there's a tachyon involved. When there's an ordinary particle involved, the tachyonic behaves, a particle behaves a certain way, and we understand that. When there's a tachyon involved, things are different
mm-hmm.
in terms of how the information being sent from the tachyon to another particle actually transpires. And that difference allows the past to start, as you move forward with your thought, the past starts bringing in information gradually to you so that you can construct sentences based upon memory.
Mm-hmm.
And sometimes when it's a complicated sentence that you're constructing, you have to go pretty deep into your memory level to find the correct construction to finish the sentence.
Sure. And at the same time, as you point out, we're dealing with information coming from the future.
Exactly. In fact, anybody can do this. If you're watching this at home, just say something, make a sentence, say it out loud. And then when you're all done saying that sentence, ask yourself, how did you know what the last word of that sentence was going to be before you uttered the sentence?
Uh-huh.
When you make a sentence, you don't know what the last word is going to be until you actually say the last word. And now, the last word was word. But when I started that sentence off, I didn't know it was going to be word until could have been pukapaka. I don't know what I'm going to say until I say it.
Right.
So the point is, yet you said it, and when you put it all mm-hmm. together, with hindsight, it's a sentence which has...
Linguists would describe that as an act of intuition.
Exactly.
Yeah.
Exactly. That's exactly what this, in a sense, mm-hmm. the tachyonic field has something to do with. It has to do information coming from the future, or if you will, tachyonic. Which
that's how you define intuition, is an appreciation of the future.
It's an awareness of the future coming back to you.
Okay.
It's the awareness which keeps you from being pounced on in ancient times by the bear outside the cave. As I say, mm-hmm. those of us in humanity that got pounced on, they're not around anymore.